Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the fifth part of my TACOM 135th scale Chieftain Mark V build. I had seen many modelers on social media make these interesting explosion effects, which inspired me greatly to have a go at it myself. There were two conditions I set for myself. Firstly, the entire effect, particularly the batteries, should be inside the kit. I did not want any wires dangling from the tank and then having to find a way to hide them in a base or something. The second condition was that the entire effect should be temporarily attached. As it is, this kit is rather large and then adding more to the barrel would make it particularly hard to store. So I thought to make the entire effect in a way that would allow me to remove it for storage and then reattach it if I felt like showing off. So with that in mind, I set about making the effect, starting by drilling through the barrel. If you remember, at every stage of assembling the barrel, firing breech and the mantlet, I had drilled holes to make way for the wiring. I now widen those holes with the drill. You may also have noticed that I have not glued the barrel in place. In fact, the barrel will not be glued in place at all. This will help me in attaching and detaching the explosion to the tank. A quick cleanup. I bought this cheap strip of LED online to light up the explosion. It comes attached to this battery case, which I have cut off so that I can pass the wire through the barrel. Also, this battery case is too wide to fit inside the tank, so we will have to make our own battery bank. This rigid metal wire will hold the entire project and explosion in place. I first get a feel of how it will go together, and then cut the metal wire to size. I now use a smaller wire to make a support jig where the white part of the explosion and the LED lights will go. I use super glue to hold the wire in place. The skeleton of the explosion will be made out of this wire mesh that I picked up at my local hobby shop. This too is glued in place with super glue. The LED strip is self-adhesive and I stick it to the mesh. Now, using some cotton and some glue spray, I shaved the explosion. The glue spray is nothing special, just regular glue you can get online. It not only holds things in place, but also helps me shape the cotton. Once the glue has dried, I paint the explosion with yellow and red. I later also added black for the shadows. Once everything was dry, it was time to give the rig a test to see how the colors would look with lights on. Nice, but perhaps a bit more color. Also, I need to build my own battery bank. I used 3 pencil cells and taped them together like this. The idea is to make them small enough to fit inside the tank. Now to wire them. There are plenty of videos on YouTube showing how to wire batteries, so I will not get into that too much. Now to test the new battery bank. I bought this aftermarket set for artillery projectiles and used one for the tank. As you can see, I tend to take a tiny bit of liberty with accuracy sometimes. The battery wires are now soldered in place, but I do not solder the battery bank to the explosion rig. That is held together by tape, just so I can remove it when I want to store the kit. Time to put everything together. Right then, fellow model makers. That's about all for this build. If you enjoyed the video series, please do hit the like button. Also, do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And don't forget to press the bell icon for future updates. Till next time, stay safe, good luck, and happy model making.